Hey, what's up guys? John here. On this channel, I talk about personal finance, real estate, business, and money. And over the last 6 months especially, it's been very, very hard to ignore the reality of what's happening to America and the world and where I see the overall economy going. There's a lot of bubbles happening right now, whether it be in meme stocks, in crypto, in real estate. There's a lot of false belief that the economy is going to continue just going. When we look at the core fundamentals of what's happening in the world, things don't make any sense. And a real good example of that is what Biden has in this infrastructure bill. Page 168 is an absolute living nightmare that we hope doesn't become our everyday reality. So Biden, this was 2 days ago. This is a townhall.com statement. A reporter asked him, how many Americans need to get it for us to go back to normal? Biden says 97 to 98%. I think we'll get awfully close, but I'm not a scientist. I think one thing is for certain, a quarter of the country can't go without it and us not continue to have a problem. So we have, as of now, about 330 million Americans. So about 85, between probably 75 and 85 million Americans haven't yet gotten it, according to the mainstream media. So for us to get to their, you know, that 98% threshold, just about everybody would need to get it. So only the top 1%, the top 2% could say no. This wouldn't be probably Joe the plumber that gets the option of saying no. And if you look at page 168, Tucker Carlson covered this yesterday. It's pretty concerning. It's almost unbelievable. Page 168, here's what it says. Going forward, the federal government will bankrupt any company that refuses to comply. Think about how insane that is. Whether you are for it or against it. You know, this is a Fox News article. I cover CNN articles all the time. I cover information on both the left and the right to give an unbiased view of what's really happening and leaving politics out of it, strictly focusing on money, our freedoms, the economy, business. But when you're going to bankrupt people's companies they've worked their entire lives for, if they don't have the money, you think about how much money this fine is going to be. You're going to be unbelievable. It's going to blow your mind. 700 grand. That's the number. $700,000 payable to the U.S. Treasury for each and every one of those workers. If you don't have that 700K, what are they going to do? Are they going to shut your company down? You damn right. Are they going to take your house? Maybe. Are they going to go into your bank account and take money? Obviously. They're not just going to take a dumb and dumber IOU and say, okay, yeah, pay us when you got it. No, they're going to come try to make an example out of the people that don't comply. And the mainstream media is likely going to take this story and blast it all over the place, whether it be on Facebook, they're going to take it on the news. They're going to make it to where they're going to have a lot of people afraid of having that same result happen to them. So everyone's just going to buckle and cave to every mandate going forward. So when we're looking at this, you know, someone passed away in a chemical plant and they were fined $12,288 for that. $12,288. And de Blasio, he said, this is just crazy to me. De Blasio said, most people, the vast majority of people, even those who say I didn't want to do it, make a different decision when it becomes very practical. So now someone is literally looking at the possibility they won't have a paycheck for a prolonged period of time. They may even lose their jobs ultimately. A lot of people are going to look at that and say, hold up, okay, I'll comply. So a lot of these people, okay, we'll take your paycheck away, we'll punch you in the face, starve you to death, we'll beat up your kids. Turns out, if you hurt people enough, they'll do exactly what you say. So that clearly works. Bill de Blasio is clearly but even he understands that. And if it does work, United Airlines just announced they're firing 600 people. Why are they doing that? They don't want to pay tens of millions of dollars in fines. So 600 people who make jobs last week are now unemployed with no health insurance. That's how they're making America healthier. Same thing is happening at the border right now. I'm hearing rumors. I'm going to show you this. I'm hearing rumors that this happens to be Fox News again, is that they're going to fire the officers at the border.